Nice, you motherfucking here today! We gotta have ourselves one hell of a rock and roll party! We don't need to be mad and stop. Make it up and it's called Six Lots of Love.
Yeah.
people. When we were backstage a couple of minutes ago, somebody came over and said, Paul, why are you calling this the Asylum Tour? I said, man, take a look out there, those motherfuckers are crazy! There's one important word in this song about the album Asylum. That one word is This song is called Thank you. what they came for. But we ain't leaving this place till a roof caves in. Morning, I looked and I said, holy Jesus, there's Kiss again. I gotta hack my job. And here's the song they were playing. It went like this.
Thank you.
people here tonight. I can tell to you people, like the audience that comes to a rock and roll concert. I don't really want to do that. I take some people. I want to talk to all the people here tonight in Greensboro, like your old friends. Are you sure?
Yeah.
I mean, I would only tell this to my friends. Are you sure?
Yeah.
Even if it's dirty!
Yeah.
Even if I'm gonna have to talk about S. E. And we landed here in your little town that we love to come book in. We got off the plane, and I tell you something. All of a sudden, the stewardess comes walking over to me. And she says, "Excuse me." She says, "Are you in a band?" I looked at her and I said, "No, I'm a doctor." I said, "I'm a doctor. And these five gentlemen here, these are the rest of the doctors. We're coming to operate tonight in Greensboro." She looked at me and she says, "I know who you are." She says, "You know something? I just gotta get an autograph for my sister." I said, "Okay." She says, "Even before I get to say any more," she says, "You know something? I would do anything for an autograph." Anything. I tell you some people, all of a sudden I looked at her and said, "Baby, I don't have much time." She said to me, "Paul, this isn't going to take much time." I said to her, "Baby, won't you hop inside my limousine, because we're going to take a ride around the world." We get into the car and she says to me, "You know something? You're going to like fly in the friendly skies of United." Be shy, why don't you make yourself comfortable? Then she looks at me and she says, "You ain't gonna stop now, why don't you take off your pants?" Somebody's over there on the side going, "Don't you do that or we're gonna have you in handcuffs." Moving around just a little bit, and all of a sudden I feel his hand grab the rise of my Levi's. All of a sudden she grabs the top of my Levi's 501s and she takes that little snap out at the top and she goes. I looked down at her and I said, "Baby, we're gonna do some first class flying here." All of a sudden she takes that next little button and she goes. I looked down at her and I said, "We have just entered the danger zone." Now all of a sudden, she takes that hand, warms it up real nice, sticks it in the front of my pants, and she goes, "With a gun that big, I'm gonna call you Rambo." She said to me, "What you packing out there?" She said, "You got a machine gun?" I said, "Baby, that ain't no machine gun." She said, "That one of those M16s?" I said, "No." I said, "I tell you one thing, the people in Greensboro, they know what I got." I said, "Honey, I want to introduce you to my..." I knew you people would let me down. I said, "I want to introduce..."
Thank you.
want you to feel the rhythm. Cause I see you got some people here tonight with real good rhythm. This is an announcement for the people who have had enough. People who have had enough, you got 30 seconds to get the fuck out, because we're going to start. Like this. Now, I know you know how to make that noise because some of you were making it last night.
Thank you.
pick something.
I got a call. I gotta go.
With me, and you have to have somebody with you, and you have to have somebody with me. Make sure.